Hello students, in the last video we had done corresponding angle axiom, then converse of corresponding angle axiom, and then theorem number 1, which states that if a transversal line intersects two parallel lines, then each pair of alternate interior angles are equal. Now we will do the converse of theorem number 1, that is name it as theorem number 2, which states that if transversal intersects two lines such that a pair of alternate interior angles is equal, then the two lines are parallel. So this is the converse of theorem number 1, because in theorem number 1 we say that we have two parallel lines and we have to prove the alternate interior angles are equal. Now we have given alternate interior angles are given and we have to prove that two lines are parallel. So let's see its proof. First of all, draw the diagram. Two lines. So we draw two lines. Then a transversal line. So we draw a transversal line. Then we have given alternate interior angles is equal. A pair of alternate interior angle is equal. So we take this pair. 1 and 2 angle are alternate interior angles. So we have given. Let AB and CD be two lines. And L is transversal line. Given angle 1 is equal to angle 2. To prove, what we have to prove? We have to prove the two lines are parallel. So we have to prove AB parallel to CD. How we will prove this? We have given angle 1 equal to angle 2. Angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Why? This is given in the statement already. Now, angle 1 and angle 3 are equal. Reason why angle 1 and angle 3 are equal? Reason is because these are the vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles. So, from both equations, what do you get? We get angle 2 is equal to angle 3. Now see, angle 2 and angle 3, both are corresponding angles. And we have done already in the last lecture that if two corresponding angles are equal, then the lines are parallel. This is the converse of corresponding angle axiom. So, AB parallel to CD, reason is converse of corresponding angle axiom. This is all what we have to prove. We proved AB parallel to CD. Next theorem, theorem number 3. States that if transversal line intersects two parallel lines such that interior angle, if transversal line intersects two parallel lines, then interior angles on same side of transversal are supplementary. Means their sum will be equal to 180 degrees. Draw the diagram. We have given transversal line intersects two parallel lines. So we had take two parallel lines L and M and one transversal line N. Here two angles on the same side of transversal and both should be interior angles. So we take this one and two, similarly three and four. So we have to prove angle 1 plus angle 2 is equal to 180 degree and angle 3 plus angle 4 is equal to 180 degree. So let L is parallel to line M and N is transversal line. To prove angle 1 plus angle 2 is equal to 180 degree and angle 3 plus angle 4 is equal to 180 degree. How we will prove this? See, let us take this angle B, 5. Now angle 1 plus angle 5 is equal to 180 degree. Why? We had done in the last lecture that this becomes a linear pair. Angle 1 and angle 5 form a linear pair. So sum of linear pair angle 1 and angle 5 forms 180 degree. So we mention here reason, linear pair. Now angle 5 and angle 2 are equal. Why angle 5 and angle 2 are equal? Because both are corresponding angles. So these are equal by corresponding angle axiom. That we done in the last video, corresponding angle axiom. So put the value of angle 5 in the first equation. Equation 1 implies angle 1 plus, put the value of angle 5 here, angle 2 is equal to 180 degrees. That is what we have to prove. Angle 1 plus angle 2 is equal to 180 degrees. Similarly, you can prove angle 3 plus angle 4 is equal to 180 degrees. Similarly, angle 3 plus angle 4 is equal to 180 degrees. This is a task for you. Do yourself. Next, theorem number 4. Theorem number 4 states that if transversal intersects two lines such that a pair of interior angles on same side is supplementary, then the lines are parallel. So now you can understand that this is the converse of theorem number 3. So proof of this theorem you will do by yourself. As I did the proof of theorem number 2, similarly you will prove theorem number 4, because theorem number 2 is converse of theorem number 1 and theorem number 4 is converse of theorem number 3. Now I will solve the one question of exercise 6.2, that is question number 5 from your NCERT book. Question number 5, exercise 6.2, diagram . So now, this is the question number 5 in your book. Diagram is given to you. Lines AB and parallel to CD is given to us. We have to find out X and Y. So how we will find it out? We have done the results that corresponding angles are equal if transversal line intersects two parallel lines, then corresponding angles are equal, alternate interior angles are equal. So now we will use those results here. Solution. See here, angle APR is equal to angle PRD. See, AB and CD are two parallel lines and this is a transversal line. PR work as a transversal line. So this angle is equal to this angle by alternate interior angle. We have done the theorem number 1, alternate interior angles. So value of APR angle is 50 and Y. So 50 degree plus Y, and value of angle PRD is 127 degree. So Y is equal to 127 degree minus 50 degree is equal to 77 degree. Now we got the value of Y. Now we'll solve the value of X. See, lines AB and CD are parallel and PQ is also a transversal line. So angle APQ and PQR are also alternate anterior angle. APQ is equal to PQR. Now value of angle APQ is 50 degree and angle PQR is X. So we got the value of X. See how interesting and easy question is this. By using alternate interior angles we get the value of Y and value of X. Here also mention alternate interior angle. So in the similar way, you can solve all the sums of exercise 6.2. By solving in this manner, you can solve all questions of exercise 6.2. Thank you, students.